one hot encoding as a bad solution. Yes, it can be true. Let's imagine, we have a data science task to handle days of week from Monday to Sunday for a machine learning model. I guess the first idea which comes to your brains is to use one hot encoding. This works as well and looks like it is represented in this table. Idea is simple. Use dummy variables for one hot encoding day of a week, 7 days, 7 rows and 7 columns. Value of 1 means actual day of week for selected example, 0 means 0. For the machine learning model, it will work. But what if we had not 7 days of week, but hundreds or thousands values which are changing in time? By applying the one hot encoding we have just discussed before, we will have a huge data table with high dimensionality and requires a lot of computational power and time. This solution will not be comfortable for your machine learning model. Just a reminder, we are talking about features which are changing in time. Days of months, days of week, and similar ones. What can we do and not fail? We need to carefully convert categorical features into numbers. It will be great to have a simple area where we can put a feature's value in some kind of cyclical coordination system. For example, based on trigonometric functions. This approach will let us to distinguish different features' values by limiting data dimensionality and prepare your data very efficiently for your machine learning model. For this, we will use one sinus formula and one cosine formula. You can see these formulas now on the screen. So, 3, 2, 1, and let's go to our Python environment and demonstrate both scenarios. First of all, let's import some Python modules and packages. Pandas for data structuring, NumPy for calculation purpose, Matplotlib for visualizing our results. Then, let's quickly define our data which we need to encode. It is just a list of days of week in our example. Nothing special here. Before showing the good approach, first of all, I want to quickly show a not very good solution. It is one hot encoding. For this, I am calling getDummies function from the pandas module. Here I am using a prefix of day. Here is it, one hot encoded table with values of days of week, 7 values, 7 rows, and 7 columns. How can we improve it? Remember, convert features into numerical values. For this special purpose, I am importing math module from Python. And from this module, I am importing p constant separately. We will use it in formulas we have just discussed before. Let's have distinct values in an array for our days of week. There will be values from 1 to 7, because we have 7 days in a week. Next thing what we have to do is to define mathematical transformation functions based on trigonometry. We will have two similar functions. One based on sinus and the other one based on cosine. Remember these functions. Let's write it in Pythonic way. Firstly, for sin transformation function, math.sin 2 multiply by p constant multiply by x and divide from maximum number of days. Transformation function based on cosine is totally the same instead of sinus. Replace it with cosine. That's it. Let's have a look at our feature data again. Now we are on the finish line. Let's calculate the numerical values for our feature data. P value based on sinus will be calculated for all days of a week at once by calling a sin transformation function. As you may have got an idea, for cosine transformation values, we will do the same, just replace sinus to cosine. Copy the full sinus transformation function and paste it into the next line of code. So here will be pcos, not psin column, and the function itself, cos, not sin, that's all. Here is our transformed feature data. Instead of a huge one hot encoded table, we have just two columns which represent all distinct values of features. This approach is very powerful and can be directly adopted to your data science project. So, to be happy with the result, I suggest to plot our feature values on a graph to get an intuition how transformation function did their job. Just simple matplotlib plot function with feature data column with calculated numerical values as arguments. Marker will be a simple dot. Let's have a marker size of 10. Line width is 0 and color is blue. Let's plot it. As you may expect to see, it is a cyclical relationship graph which represents our feature values and understandable for machine learning models in a very powerful format. I hope this quick tutorial was useful for you. If you have some specific questions, let me know. Suggest a topic for the next video and see you there. Never stop learning. Bye-bye.